So using law of conservation of energy, we can find that V1 square minus V2 square. So for to solve P1 minus T2 is equal to M by R, V1 minus, so that is V1 square minus V2 square plus 2mg. So at point 1, so at point 1 is that lowest point. So here, so this is the lowest point, this is the highest point. So at lowest point, here potential energy is equal to 0, because it is not lifted to a certain height h. So potential energy is equal to 0, but it moves with certain velocity. So kinetic energy is equal to half m v1 square. So this is the lowest point, this is the highest point, this is the motion of vertical circle. So the total energy is sum of potential energy and kinetic energy, so half m v1 square. Then at point 2, that is the highest point, so the object is lifted to a certain height h. So that is the radius of the circle r, so that is we are rotating. So at point 2, that potential energy is equal to mgh, so that h is equal to, so here also r, so it is lifted to a height h, so h is equal to 2r. So mgh, so instead of h just use 2r. Then kinetic energy, so kinetic energy, that is half mv square, that is the velocity, it moves with velocity v2, so this is the velocity. So the total energy is mg2r plus half m v2 square. So using the law of conservation of energy, so energy at the lowest point and highest point are same. So E1 equal to E2. Just compare, so half m V1 square is equal to mg into 2r plus half m V2 square. So that half m V2 square goes to that left hand side. So half m is common. So V1 square minus V2 square, that is equal to mg into 2r. So here that mass cancel, then 2 goes to that right hand side, so 2 into 2 4, so 4gr, so v1 square minus v2 square equal to 4gr. So t1 minus c2 is equal to m by r, that v1 square minus v2 square, so instead we are using that 4gr. So here r cancel, you will get 4mg plus 2mg, you will get 6mg. So t1 minus t2, the tension in the string 1 and 2, just if subtract, you will get 6mg, that is the value. If you know the value of mass of that mass, then acceleration due to gravity, you can find the tension in the string. Then minimum speed at the highest point, so what is the velocity? So what is the velocity at the highest point? So this is the highest point. So the tension in the string, so that is T2 equal to mv2 squared by r minus mg. Then if it is for minimum, so the tension in the string just consider 0, so that plus mg goes to right hand side, so plus, so that minus becomes plus, so mv2 squared by r is equal to mg. So just that mass cancel, so v2 squared equal to gr, so r goes to that right hand side, so v2 equal to square root of gr. So the minimum velocity, so at the highest point, so highest point, it goes against the gravity, so it is a vertical circle, so it is moving, so it goes against gravity, loses the velocity. At the highest point, it is minimum velocity, somewhat very less, so v2 equal to square root of gr, so greater than or equal to square root of gr. Then minimum speed at the lowest point, so it goes like that, so it goes like that, so it comes towards gravity, so its velocity is somewhat very high compared to the highest point. So that v1 minus v2, so we find that v2 square root of gr, so we know that v1 square minus v2 square equal to 4gr, so this one, so just substitute, so v2 square, that is square root of gr, the square root cancels gr, so that gr goes to that right hand side, you will get plus gr, so it's 4 plus 1 5gr, so that v1 square is equal to 5gr, so v1 equal to square root of 5gr. So just compare, so velocity at the lowest point and highest point, so velocity at the highest point is square root of 5 times the velocity at the highest point. So velocity at the lowest point, so the lowest point is higher than highest point, that is point 1 and 2, so the lowest point is somewhat greater compared to, that is square root of 5 times. So they may ask in 5 marks, they may ask in 1 marks also. So what is the minimum velocity at the lowest point? What is the velocity at the highest point? So which velocity is greater?